On September 11, 2023, two dams outside the city of Derna in Libya catastrophically failed after they were overwhelmed by a tropical storm. The city of Derna went from this to this, completely swept away by the failure of the two dams, killing over 11,000 people. Despite the devastating losses, this is not an isolated case. Dam failure and collapse have significantly increased in recent years, while new dam construction have significantly fallen in the past 4 decades. In fact, all dams are actually being removed all around the world. Why is this trend happening? And what is so inherently dangerous about dams that all of a sudden dam failure increased rapidly? Well, the answer to this question is linked to 4 reasons, with the first one being the aging dam infrastructure. Dam construction really took off in the early 20th century, between 1950 and 1990. Dams were used for all sorts of purposes, but the main ones were irrigation, hydropower, water supply, and flood control. This boom resulted in the construction of different types of dams, from small 5-meter dams to mega dams 15 meters and above. However, the design and construction of these dams were not as advanced as today. It's not that dam construction in the 1950s was poor, or they cut a lot of corners, but back then we had limited understanding of soil mechanics, considering that the majority of dams built back then were embankment dams constructed from compacted soil and rocks with impervious core. Most of these dams had only 50 years of design life, 100 years at best for bigger concrete dams. Dams are static structures that deal with very unpredictable dynamic loads. The pressure from the water held by the dam changes throughout the year. The dam has to adjust constantly by safely discharging excess water without damaging the dam's main structural components. As dams get older, they do need to be inspected for cracks, structural deficiencies, and the condition of the soil and embankments. Cracks on the structures can lead to corrosion of the steel or erosion of soil materials, reducing the structure's strength and leading to leaks and eventually sudden collapse. But this is not the only thing facing dams. Foundation issues are the second reason why dams are failing. While a dam holds water on the surface, it is not the same underground. Water does flow underground from high to low areas. If this is not well understood, it can lead to soil erosion or erosion of dam materials, which may compromise the dam's structural integrity. In the worst cases, it can result in a phenomenon known as piping, which happens when seeping water erodes fine particles from soil within or beneath the dam, creating voids or channels. Over time, these channels can grow larger, potentially leading to settlements and catastrophic dam failure. If the dam or its foundation is built on poorly compacted or loose soils, water seepage and settlement can happen much faster, leading to failure. To prevent this issue, continuous monitoring and analysis of water flow can help us to introduce control measures such as cutoff walls or drainage systems. Unfortunately, many of those old dams are not properly monitored. Most dam failures can be preventable if they have been adequately maintained and regularly inspected. However, poor maintenance of dam is something common with all of those dam failures, which we will get into later in this video. While the first two reasons are quite serious on their own, the next two reasons are actually why dams collapse. Dam overtopping happens when the dam water level exceeds the dam capacity due to heavy rainfall or rapid snowmelt. Water can flow over the top of the dam. While dams have spillways to allow for the discharge of excess water, when the dam spillway cannot discharge water fast enough or when the dam is being filled faster than discharging, it can cause soil and material erosion, weakening the dam structure. Overtopping can also overwhelm the dam, and it can reach a point where the dam level exceeds the capacity of the structure, which puts a lot of pressure on the dam and can tip the dam, and in some cases it can slide the dam, leading to a sudden failure. These are very common dam failures that result from inadequate emergency response plan during storms and flood seasons. Dam overtopping does happen more often due to climate change, which increases rainfall and storms more frequently, leading to higher water levels and greater pressures on dams, exceeding the dam's design capacity and leading to failure. A lot of dams back in the day were not designed for extreme scenarios, which means most of those dams cannot discharge water fast enough. If a dam is deemed to be unable to discharge water quickly in such situations, it should be operated at a lower than normal level to provide a head start for dam spillways to discharge excess water. it is hard to predict the prospect of many dams since most are poorly maintained. As dams age, their power output is reduced, while their maintenance costs skyrocket. Since dams hold free-flowing water, they also accumulate a lot of sediments. Over time, sediments can accumulate in the reservoir behind the dam, reducing its storage capacity for irrigation, water supply, and flood control. It can also affect the efficiency of turbines and reduces electricity production. It increases the risk of dam overtopping. It can also affect the operation of spillways, not to mention altering water quality, increasing turbidity, and reducing oxygen levels in water. While this would not be a problem if dams are maintained, sediments are managed and removed on times, or dams were flushed on regular basis. But what is happening is shocking. As the cost of maintenance increases, it becomes difficult to maintain dams. Many get abandoned or neglected, which eventually leads to catastrophic failures during flooding seasons. Structures that have disastrous impacts are regularly inspected and maintained, but the difference with dams is that most are owned by private entities. Just in the US, 65% of all dams are owned by private entities. Those private entities usually neglect those dams as their power and water output decline and become obsolete. This, over time, raises the cost of maintenance, which usually lead to abandonment. The American Society of Civil Engineers estimate that the cost of fixing the dams whose failure would threaten lives at roughly $45 billion, and the cost of fixing all aging dams are over $64 billion. Some sources estimate that at current reservoir sedimentation rates, the existing global reservoir storage capacity could be nearly halved by 2100. This means a reduction of dam output and eventually abandonment, which result in more and more dam failures, which is similar to what happened to the dams in Libya. Poor maintenance coupled with failure to release excess water on time led to overwhelming of the dams by Storm Daniel, which led to a sudden collapse of these dams, loss of lives, and destruction of a city. The decline of dam construction over the years is a clear indication of how expensive it is to construct, operate, and maintain dams. While most dams are used for irrigation, hydropower, and flood control, advancement in those areas have rendered many current dams redundant. Renewable energy sources have proven to be at least way more efficient than dam hydropower over the long run. Reservoirs and ponds can be constructed without building large dams that can capture and store water for irrigation and flood control in more localized and environmentally friendly manner, without the need to block the river's mainstream. Dams change topography and the landscape of the areas, displacing wildlife and destroying the ecosystem. It takes years to plan and construct a dam and very long time to fill the dam before you can have a fully operating dam. Just look at the conflict between Ethiopia and Egypt. Filling the new Grand Ethiopian Renaissance Dam will take years, and filling the dam too quickly means cutting the flow of the Nile and causing drought downstream in Egypt. Due to those reasons and the rapid failure of dams, as most are expected to age and pass their design lifespan by 2050, it is predicted that dam failure will increase more and more if actions are not taken. It is safe to say that we are unlikely to see another dam construction boom, since building new dams means that we eventually have to deal with aging structures. Around 85% of US dams have reached their life expectancy. The cost of repairing those structures is very expensive. The same goes for maintenance, as it means spending more money on structures that do not have the same power output as other sources and only delaying the inevitable collapse of those dams. Luckily, there is a solution currently happening, which is dam removal. Dam removal is really taking off recently, with the US being the leader in it. As the cost of maintenance and repair escalates of aging dams, these costs can be 10 to 30 times more expensive than dam removal. In addition, climate change may accelerate dam aging, thus increasing the cost even more. Removal of dams restores the natural flow of the river and the ecosystem by releasing sediments. Yet removing a dam is not an easy task. It takes years to plan and remove a dam, even for a small one. However, dam removal is not always a viable option. Dams are critical infrastructures for low-income countries to provide clean water for drinking and irrigation. and provide reliable clean energy source. This means maintaining the structures is the only way to keep those structures from collapsing. Thus, implementing a one-size-fits-all solution to all aging dams is not possible, and every case should be analyzed individually. On the other hand, not all dams are at risk of collapsing, as many serve a vital role for flood control, generating power, and water for irrigation. Removal of those dams can be a big loss on so many levels. But whether a dam is to be removed partially or entirely, decommissioning is much less costly than repairing or rebuilding. Public safety is a growing concern of these aging dams. The collapse of such dams, like the ones we've seen in Libya, can threaten the lives of many people. If actions are not taken, we are likely to see more and more dam failures over the upcoming years.